Welcome to module 2 of our Spring Boot application. In the last lesson, we created a very basic Spring Boot or basically a very basic REST controller. It was just returning a string. But we also talked a little bit about, okay, how do the Spring Boot, or let's me to put it in a different way, what are the changes I need to put in place if I want to return a complex object, okay? So in this lesson, what we are going to do is we are going to extend our previous example, and instead of sending a very simple string out of our controller, we are going to send a complex object. And on top of it, we are going to see what are the powers or the flexibility Spring Boots bring into the picture, and what are the different or the additional configurations which we may have to do in order to return a complex object from our REST controller. So let's see that in action. So this was our example from our previous lesson. We are going to keep building our shopping cart application. So in this lesson, let's build a new controller which is going to return a complex object. And since we are working onto the shopping cart application, I think let's create an example where our controller is going to return a product, or are going to return a list of the products. Because if you have a shopping cart, you really want to add a product to your shopping cart, right? So let's build our, we are going to do two things, in fact. We are going to create a new controller, and we are also going to create a product object or a product being, which is going to represent the product in itself, okay? So let's, the first thing what we are going to do is, we are going to create our product or the product object or product being, whatever you want to call it. So I'm going to call it as a data product, because we are going to create a different kind of objects. Right, let's create our class, which is going to be product. Let's call it as a product data. Okay, what all we need for this one? Because it's a product, we need a code, which is going to uniquely defining a our product, right? We need a name for our product. We name description for our product. Of course, we need price for our product. And let's add a stock to our product, okay? Now I'm quickly going to add some constructor. Let's add a no argument constructor. And that's enough. We really don't need to add the other constructor. Let's quickly add the getter and setters, okay? So this is our product data object. This is the object which our controller is going to return back to the, or our REST controller is going to return back to the REST client, okay? The next thing what we are going to do is, we are going to build our product controller. This product controller is going to return. All right, so let's create our product controller. I'm going to annotate this with the REST controller, which says, okay, this is my REST controller, okay? What I'm going to say is, okay, this is going to return the product data, or the list of the product data in short, okay? We call it as a get products, because it's a list, so end with products, okay? For the sound, right? This is a list, okay? The next thing what we are going to do is, let me to increase the font a little bit, okay? The next thing I'm going to say, this is this method is going to accept only the get request for the products as an URI mapping, okay? Now, typically, what we used to do is, we should have a service layer which is going to return the list of the products. Of course, that service layer maybe probably is going to talk to the data access object layer or the DAO layer to fetch all the products. But for the simplicity of this lesson, what I'm going to do is I'm going to mock that method in the same controller, which is going to return the list of the products. Okay, so let's create that method in our controller. So this is our kind of we are mocking our service. So this is nothing fancy. What I'm returning is just a list of the product, filling it with some dummy data, iterating the loop and all those things. Okay, from this one, what I'm going to say is I'm going to return our products. All right, so this controller is almost complete. So let's restart our application, or let's start our application, and then we are going to see how this is going to react to our how this is going to respond to our REST controller. Okay, see that in action. Okay, so this was our first controller with greeting methods. Now what we are going to do is we are going to say the products. Voila, right? So we have the response because we iterated our loop for 3 times with some dummy data, so we have all the results back from our control. Okay, let's take another look to our controller. There are a couple of different things, right? The only difference between our greeting controller, which is this one, right, and our product controller is the return type. Everything else is same, of course, apart from the mapping, which is always going to be a little bit different. But other than that, if you see, our greeting controller was returning a string with us. static string back as part of our REST controller response. Our product controller is returning a list of the product data, but there are a number of different things happening behind the scene for us, right? If you already have an experience on working onto a Spring MVC application or any web application, you may have noticed those differences, but let's reiterate those one, which is going to give us a better understanding about the Spring Boot features as well as its capabilities. So the first thing which we immediately saw is that the return or the response which the REST controller got back from the REST controller is this JSON data, right? But in our application, let's do a side-by-side comparison, okay, for a better understanding. All right, but if you see in our REST controller, there is nothing where we say I want to return a JSON of data, right? Or let's say if it's a JSON data, there is no converter, there is nothing, there is no special code or no extra code which is converting this list of the product data into this JSON. This is automatically being taken care of by the Spring Boot, right? There are a number of different things. If you're not familiar with, there is a concept as the HTTP converters, message converters, which are being provided by the Spring MVC application for you. But Spring Boot is a little bit more intelligent than that. If you remember our initial lessons, I was talking about when you make an application as a web application, there are a couple of things which are being automatically added by the Spring Boot. One of those dependency is the JSON dependency. These are the dependencies I'm talking about. These are automatically added by the Spring Boot, and the HTTP default HTTP message converters are being configured automatically for your Spring Boot applications. Okay, so in short, you haven't written anything saying, okay, how do I want to convert the JSON, but that has been automatically taken care of by the Spring Boot. You are normally returning a list of the complex object, right? And everything else will be taken care of by the Spring Boot automatically. There was another thing which I was talking on to the first lesson. Because of the REST controller and because of this response body, the things are being automatically taken care of for you by the Spring Boot. All right, so that's all for this lesson. I really want to my idea was to highlight a couple of different things for better understanding. And one of the very critical thing or very important thing which we understood is there are multiple things which are being taken care of by the Spring Boot, right? You are basically, for you are just working as a normal controller, right? You're just returning a list of the product data, but other things are being automatically taken care of by the Spring Boot based upon what is the accepted content type being requested by the by your REST client. Things are automatically being taken care of by the Spring Boot. I hope that this lesson is going to give you a better understanding about the Spring Boot application as well as some of the features and the capabilities of the Spring Boot. We will continue to evolve our sample application along with we will continue to get a deeper understanding of the different features of the Spring Boot. All right, thank you.